Hi, this is Sikuru Fei from Spektro Audio, and I'm here today to show you how you can get started using NGEN, our algorithmic MIDI workstation. NGEN is a multi-track MIDI sequencer that offers a variety of different MIDI generators and effects that it can combine to create and manipulate sequences in real time. You can use it to sequence instruments during live performances, or to create parts and even entire songs while in the studio. In this video, I'll walk you through how to set up NGEN and how to get started making some music with it. Before we talk about the setup, let's quickly walk through NGEN's hardware. It features a USB-C connection that is used for both USB communication as well as for power, MIDI input and output via 3.5 jacks, 4 CV outs, one I2C connection on the side, one micro SD card slot on the front, 4 potentiometers, 4 main buttons, the OLED display, one return button, and the menu encoder. The menu encoder and the return button let us navigate through the menu system and adjust different settings and parameters. The main 4 buttons are track, clock, pattern, function, and generate. The generate button is NGEN's most essential button, and it will let us generate sequences and patterns using our generators. The function button works as a modifier button to let us access different functions. The track, clock, and pattern buttons will let us navigate between clocks, tracks, and patterns. We can also use different combinations of these buttons to access shortcuts available in NGEN. Last but not least are the 4 potentiometers, labeled param 1 through 4. These 4 potentiometers will let us access the most important parameters of our generators, as well as other type of parameters, under certain menus. So let's plug in the unit and get started. The easiest way of using NGEN is to connect it to a computer and a DAW using a USB cable. We'll talk more about other setups in future videos. To sync NGEN to my DAW, I first need to make sure that I'm sending MIDI clock messages from my DAW to NGEN. In this demo, I'll be using Ableton Live, so I'll open Live Settings and enable sync for the output MIDI port to NGEN. After booting up, NGEN launches into the main menu, as we can see in the top left corner of the display. Using the menu encoder, I can navigate through the main menu to access the main features available in NGEN, such as the settings for the active generator, MIDI effect, track, scale, clock, and more. Clicking the menu encoder will navigate into the selected submenu. I can always return to the previous menu by clicking the return button. The first three submenus available in the main menu are the generator, MIDI effects, and track. These three submenus are related to the settings and parameters available for the currently selected track, while the other ones, such as scale, perform, and so on, are related to global features. We can select a different track by pressing the track lock button, selecting a different track with the encoder, and pressing the menu encoder to confirm. By default, NGEN boots with MIDI clock enabled and AcidGen loaded as the generator for the first track. Also by default, the output of the 16 tracks available in NGEN are mapped to the 16 MIDI channels available. I already have some virtual instruments loaded in my DAW. So to get started, I'll set up my synth bass track to listen to NGEN's MIDI channel 1. Now, if I press play on my DAW, NGEN will start playing and I can then use the AcidGen generator to sequence my bass. If I press the generate button, I can generate a completely new sequence using NGEN. To access the parameters of the current active generator, in this case AcidGen, we can navigate into the generator submenu from the main menu. Because AcidGen is the active generator for track 1, the generator submenu will display the parameters available for this generator. While in the submenu, I can see the name of the active generator on the top left corner, the selected track number on the top right corner, and a list of parameters and functions that I can access using the menu encoder. I can change the value of a parameter by clicking on the menu encoder to access its value, scrolling the encoder to adjust it, and then clicking the encoder again to return to the list navigation. The default behavior for the 4 potentiometers in NGEN is to control the main parameters of the generator that I'm using. So with AcidGen, we have shift on param 1, length on param 2, density on param 3, and accent on param 4. I can also access 4 additional parameters by holding down the function button. As you can see, when I hold function to access a different parameter, I first see this screen with a horizontal bar and a triangle, indicating a position. This is the pickup screen, and it's there because of how the potentiometers work in NGEN. Because these potentiometers can control different parameters, depending on the generator, track, and submenu, when a potentiometer is set to control a different parameter, NGEN first expects you to physically move the potentiometer to the position of the current value for that parameter before you can start changing it. So whenever you see the screen, just move the potentiometer until it reaches the position indicated by the triangle. If I stop interacting with NGEN for a couple of seconds while in the generator submenu, NGEN will start showing the animation for the generator that I'm using. So now, let's try using a different generator. To change the active generator, let's return to the main menu and navigate to Track. Track contains the settings for the selected track, which is also indicated by the number on the top right corner. From the submenu, we can enable or disable a track and select a different generator and MIDI effect. There are also some other settings available via the advanced mode. I'll scroll to Generator and select the next generator, the Arper, and press the encoder again to confirm. Now NGEN has instantly changed the active generator of track 1 into Arper, and has already generated a new sequence using it. I can now use the potentiometers to control the main parameters in Arper, or navigate back into the generator submenu to access all the available parameters. Now let's see how we can use MIDI effects to further process and manipulate our sequence. Each track in NGEN can also run one MIDI effect of your choosing. To select a MIDI effect, navigate to the track settings and select one of the available MIDI effects. Let's try using the glitch MIDI effect first. To access the different parameters available for the active MIDI effect, return to the main menu and select the MIDI effects submenu. Notice that while we're in the submenu, we see an icon on the top that is somewhat similar to a knob. This icon indicates that while in the submenu, the four potentiometers are being used to control something else other than the generator parameters. So in this case, it's the parameters for the glitch MIDI effect. When we return to the main menu, the knob icon disappears, and I can use the potentiometers to control my generator again. So now that we have looked into how we can navigate around NGEN and set up a track, let's create a song using three tracks. One for drums, one for bass, and one for keys. I'll start by setting up three tracks in my DAW with the instruments I want to use, and set each one of them to listen to a different MIDI channel from NGEN. Let's begin by creating a drum sequence using DrumGen. From the main menu, go to Track, Generator, and select DrumGen. This generator uses a house template by default, and I can generate a new drum sequence by pressing the Generate button. I can also press Function and Generate to access a secondary function for this generator. In this case, I can select a different template. Now let's add our bass track. I use the Function and Track shortcut to jump to my track settings, go to Track 2, and then activate it. It's already set to Acidgen, so I don't need to change anything else. Finally, let's add our third track. I'll open the track settings again, select track number 3, activate it, and then I'll select the pop generator. Whenever I'm happy with the sequences that I have, I can save the current pattern to one of the 8 available pattern slots. Press Pattern to open the pattern selector. Select which pattern slot you would like to save to, and then press Function and Pattern to open the pattern edit menu. From here, I can select the Save option to save the pattern. After I've saved my pattern, I can create a second pattern and alternate between them. Thank you. Finally, we can save all our 8 patterns as a project in NGEN. Projects can be stored either in NGEN's internal memory or into a micro SD card. To save a project, we turn to the main menu, scroll to Projects, and select Save. If you'd like to know more about all the features available in NGEN, check the NGEN user manual at spektroaudio.com/NGEN. Until next time, and as always, thanks for watching.